Each day, these vessels make 18 trips with 400 passengers by close of business at 6 p.m. The government in 2013 contracted Kalangala Infrastructure Services Limited to avail ferries that can connect Kalangala to Masaka via Lake Victoria. What worries the entity is that this contract is ending by 31st December 2024 and the government hasn't responded regarding the renewal of this contract. They are estimating to keep the vessels operational. Islanders will have to pay between 2,000 and 3,000 shillings per trip.
We have already, engaged a number of stakeholders, including Ministry of Works and Transport, which is our line ministry, to ensure that this subsidy is renewed for the good of the people of Kalangala.
Annually, these vessels make 52,000 crossings. In a bid to serve islanders effectively during this festive season, the company resorted to adding in more trips for increased traffic on both sides of Bugoma and Bukakata.
But people, the most important message here, people should plan well for their journeys to utilize these middle trips.
The increase in trips has warmed the hearts of travelers. According to them, they have always been rushing to catch up with ferry times, resulting in accidents. Travelers have increased as well as vehicles. Additional trips will help in times of emergencies and curb accidents resulting from overspeeding. Furthermore, islanders want the government to add a clause in KIS contract allowing them to operate at night so that Kalangala is joined in the national market, where they can sell their harvests as early as 5 a.m.
Ferry transports all over the world are supposed to be free. A person who is sick and does not have any coin in his pocket can walk to the ferry, go cross free of charge, and walk to the hospital and get treatment. But if you say that ferries will be paid for at one point beyond 2025, then you are saying that even treatment for those people who cannot afford water transport is being curtailed.
Ferries are the major Kalangala district inlet, mainly via Masaka, carrying lorries of merchandise to and fro the district, as well as other cargo and hundreds of passengers. Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.